Rajeev, please join us. We are running a little, you know, out of time, so we'll keep it very crisp. Yeah, please walk us through Ito Motors. Yeah.
First of all, thank you very much, Shanta, and also the rest of the team. India has been a great nation. Of course, it is a great nation. And we are thriving in all aspects. But certain hard facts hit us very bad. These are like this. 14 of the 15 most polluted cities in the world are in India. While the World Health Organization says that the maximum permissible levels of 2.5 particulate matter is around 10 milligrams per cubic meter, Kanpur records 170. Not just that, transport sector alone contributes to 30% for this air pollution. And definitely not to mention about our oil dependency. It is expected to touch $300 billion by 2030. While the world celebrates 2021 as a year of, I would say, sustainability, I think for India, it begins from now. And every year needs to be a year of sustainability. And the government of India has got a great ambitious, I would say, target. And also all the people of us have great, I would say, responsibility to ensure that this country is sustainable, habitable, and I would say a flourishable, I would say, land for our future generations. While I mention this, we also need to understand that the automobile industry as such contributes to more than 7% to the country's GDP right now. And Indian market is the fourth largest market in the world, and it is aspiring to become the third largest in the world very soon. So with all this happening, right, on one hand, we need to reduce the pollution. On the other hand, we cannot let go the leadership role from the, I would say, the automobile. And then the only solution here is the switching to electric mobility revolution. And we are very proud to say that Ito Motors took the lead in taking that good move of, I would say, sustainable mobility forward. And we have been operational. I mean, the team here is very passionate about the sustainable mobility. And we are not just a single player. We are basically an ecosystem, I would say. Tell you the results, right? I'll talk about the results and then I'll tell you how we have done it. The results are, within probably less than a year of operations from, as of now, close to 1 million packets have been delivered through electric vehicles. If at all you are based out of Hyderabad and you're ordering through Amazon, Big Basket, Flipkart, don't be surprised that one of your packets is delivered through our electric vehicle. And we have saved, we have run close to 2 million kilometers, green kilometers, which is equivalent to saving 2 lakh kgs of carbon dioxide being emitted into these, and equivalent to planting 4,500 plus trees. That means without literally doing the afforestation, we have created 15 acres of forest in the city of Hyderabad by curbing the, the CO2 being. How is it that we are doing all of this? We follow a 3E principle. The 3E principle is very simple. The first E stands for environment. The numbers which I spoke stand for it. And then the second E is very interesting, which stands for empowerment. Now, at this point of time, let me tell you, Shanta, India's first EV zone, which is Kevadia, where a Patel statue is there. We are very proud to say that Ito Motors vehicles, right, the passenger electric vehicles are run at Kevadia, and those are run by the tribal women, right, with least intervention in terms of training, with least equipment knowledge, right, but they're able to run. And we encourage women entrepreneurs, even in the state of Telangana. Thank you very much for the government. We have our first, I would say, women pilot who has owned an electric vehicle, and then she starts running them. And not only in terms of the cargo deliveries, we also run our passenger vehicles in almost 20 plus stations in Delhi and Noida put together as we talk at this point of time, and also in Nagpur. Right now, we are operational in Hyderabad, Bangalore, Delhi, Nagpur, and very soon we are also spreading across Pune, Mumbai, Vizag, Vijayawada, and the rest of the cities. Let's look at our, the smaller milestones and accomplishments. We are always confronted with this question, the chicken or egg question, right? Is it the vehicles first or is it the charging infra? I don't want to leave any stone unturned because our team carries the, experience of installing 25 megawatt of, with 5 megawatt complex charging infrastructure set up at just one, station in Pune. So with that, we are also now offering the charging infra facilities. We are converting, housing societies into EV friendly. We are opening up, at this point of time, we'd like to seek your support of how Telangana government and we can come together and convert some of the public places, into EV charging places. And while we reflect upon, we are always reminded of this great statement made by one of the greatest human beings ever lived on the earth. And then the statement goes like this: our work maybe, but that ocean will be lessened because of that missing trough. And this is made by great late Mother Teresa. So we are very happy to be present here at the Thai Sustainability Summit. And thank you very much for the lot of, I would say Telangana government has created an ecosystem, especially in the sustainability and electric mobility revolution, that anybody who comes with an idea can actually flourish. And from this forum, I would really like to make this call and appeal to different stakeholders who are there. If you need fleet operator services, please reach out to us. We will, as we are running to players like Amazon, Big Basket, we are happy to ferry. If you're looking for passenger mobility, again, reach out to us. We are a technology player who wants to, I would say, try something in the EV ecosystem, and you're looking for a testing ground, don't worry. And we are there. And thank you very much. And
thank you, Rajeev.
I think I've made it as crisp as possible. Yeah, open to you, please.
So, a phenomenal job. And, Mr. Rawal said, like, you guys are helping, the government of Telangana in kind of giving inputs on the policy, the EV policy. And we do have a very, dynamic director, who is at the helm of this, the EV sector. You put it very well, and I don't have any questions for you. Thank you so much for joining today. And we'll keep in touch.
Thank you very much, Shanta.
Thank you
very much. Thank you.